Alright, we're going to go over evaluating algebraic expressions. These will be basic ones, there will be no negative numbers. So to evaluate an expression, replace each variable with a specified number. So you have to be told what number to plug in for a variable, and then use the order of operations to simplify. So here are a couple examples. Evaluate each expression if x equals 2, n equals 1, and y equals 5. So let's do number 1. 4y squared minus xn. My first suggestion is anytime you have something with exponents that you write it as multiplication first. So that's what I'm going to do first for number 1. I'm going to write y squared as y times y. So I have 4 times y times y, and remember xn means x times n. The reason I'm writing this as y times y is so you realize it doesn't mean 4y times 4y. The base is just the y, so it's 4 times y squared. So now we could plug in the values of y, x, and n. So we have 4 times 5 times 5 minus x is 2, so we'll put in 2 for x, and n is 1. And now we're going to do our order of operations. So we could do our little underlining method. So I have 4 times 5 times 5, that's 100, minus 2 times 1 is 2, so my final answer is 98. So the value of this expression is 98 when x equals 2, n equals 1, and y equals 5. Now, you might not have all the variables in a particular expression. For instance, in number 2, there's a y and there's an x, but there's no n. But we do exactly the same thing. I'm going to start off by writing x squared as x times x plus 1. Now, this is a suggestion. You don't have to do that. All right, so y, we're going to replace y with a 5. And we're going to replace x with 2. And what do I have here? 5 over, now in the bottom I've got 4 plus 1. And now I have to simplify the denominator still. I'm going to run out of room here. I'm going to have to move up a little. So we have 5 over 5. And then 5 divided by 5 is 1. So the final answer here will simply be 1. Okay, here's a couple more to try. So for the first one, number 3, we're going to replace y with 5, x with 2, and n with 1. Alright, so for 5 halves, you can either leave that as 5 halves, or you could write that as a decimal, which would be 2.5, or you can write it as 2.5. So there are different ways you might deal with this 5 divided by 2. I'm going to go ahead and write it as 2.5. So I'm just changing it to a mixed number, minus, and then 2 times 1. Notice what I'm doing is I'm just doing division and multiplication as it occurs from left to right. I do my subtraction last. So we have 2.5 minus 2, and so my answer is 1/2. Now, if you had written it as 2.5 minus 2, you might have written your answer as 0.5. And if you would have left it as 5 halves and got a common denominator for 2 of 4 halves, you would have probably written it as 1/2. So those are really all the same answer, and 3 different people may do it 3 different ways. All right, let's go on to number 4. So I first have to replace the variables with the correct substitutions. So for n, I'm going to put in 1, and for y, I'm putting in 5. And now, again, remember your order of operations. You do not do the 3 plus 2. We do inside parentheses first. So we copy up to that point. And now what? We've done inside parentheses, right? Now we have to do exponents. And my suggestion which you don't have to take. You can write 2 times 36, or you could write 2 times 6 times 6 first. In any case, at your next step, you will get 72, because next you do your multiplication. Do not add till the end. So my final answer here is going to be 75. So here are a couple more problems. All right, so for number 5, there are no parentheses. Next thing, So here are a couple more problems. So we're going to replace the variables with particular numbers. But when you have exponents, I think it's easier to first write the exponents, what they mean, before replacing the variables. So if we do that, I could first write this as y times y, x times y times y, minus x times x. All right, now we could replace it. So it's up to you whether you want to replace it before then or not. So I'm going to replace x with a 2, y with a 5, and x with a 2. So what do we have here? We've got 10 times 5, or 50, minus 2 times 2 is 4, and that's 46. Here's what it would look like if you replaced it first. So starting out with the same problem, xy squared minus x squared. I'm replacing again 2 for x. I could put in the 2 for x, right? And then I'd have to be careful. 2's not being squared. I'm going to put in 5 for y. So you could put the 5 in parentheses, or you could write it as just 5 squared. You do have to be careful, though, if when we do work with negative numbers, you must put negative numbers in parentheses if you're putting in for a base with something with the exponent. And then we would have minus, and then of course I'd be putting in the 2 for the x as well. So you would either write it like this, or if you want, you could put parentheses around the 5 or each of the 2. So that's really up to you. So some people might write it like this. And in fact, if you want, you could also write the 2 in parentheses. That's all up to you. Okay, so now I have to do my order of operations first. So within this first term, I'm going to have to do the 5 squared. So I would have 2 times 25. And over here, my t squared is 4. So notice I would still end up with 50 minus 4, which is 46. People make less mistakes, fewer mistakes, I believe, when they first rewrite what something means to be squared before replacing the variable. All right, let's do the second problem over here. N plus y over n plus x. So I'm going to replace n with a 1 and y with a 5. And in the denominator, I'm going to replace n with 1 and x with a 2. Now, you cannot cancel. Remember, you need to simplify the numerator and simplify the denominator first. It's as if they're in parentheses. So 1 plus 5 is 6. 1 plus 2 is 3, and this reduces, actually, 6 divided by 3 to just the number 2. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.